Welcome to my city, Mr. Nassif. I've been expecting you. I hope you brought a fine choice of deck.
Let's sure roll. Did.
What do you want?
Higher?
Higher roll, sure.
Welcome to the Cardmarket feature match. I'm still on my quest being undefeated, and today, I mean, I upgraded Andrea to Nassif. Welcome. And we're gonna play some magic today. What are we playing?
We're playing Pioneer, our expertise, area of expertise.
Well, new favorite format of every pro that is magic existence.
It is gonna become our area of expertise soon.
Yeah, if you're gonna start Pioneer, this is where you want to see the first decks to be played. And if you want to see more of the content, click the subscribe button somewhere there, like the video, comment what do you think, what is your favorite Pioneer deck, so other people can maybe sort that out, where to start. And maybe, yeah, you like the gameplay of Pioneer, we can do lots of more. Comment, subscribe, and see you in the game. So we're gonna play Pioneer, and the deck I brought is Ascendancy Combo. And it's pretty fairly easy. Usually people say like combo decks, a bit of a difficult thing to play, but here you actually only have two cards you want to have. You have an Ascendancy, Jeskai Ascendancy in particular. You have Sylvan Awakening, you mash them together, you win the game. Fairly easy. Jeskai Ascendancy lets your creatures untap and gives them +1/+1, and the Awakening makes all your land creatures. So as you can see, they work together. And then eventually when you cast like a few spells, they get bigger, you loot and attack your opponent for roughly infinite.
So for today's Pioneer video, I decided to bring Blue-White Control. I actually haven't played a ton of Pioneer at all in the past almost 2 years, maybe a few events here and there, but nothing serious. And I know Blue-White Control is quite good, especially since they added the Wandering Emperor was one of the last sets. So yeah, pretty straightforward. Counter spells, Teferi Hill, Dominaria, card drawing spells, cycling spells, Shark, Typhoon, Removal, Sweepers, the classic. And we'll see what Thoralf brings. Excited to play some Pioneer. Hopefully I don't mess up too badly because I'm gonna be a little rusty. And yeah, let's see what happens. 7, quite average. Mm.
Is it enough? It is. That looks good. We have both of the combo parts. We have a little bit of card selection, some lands. Couldn't honestly be better. If Nassif is playing anything that is only creature related, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna win this game easily on turn 4.
I will keep as well. If he's playing some kind of aggressive deck, I might be in trouble. I have some cheap-ish interaction. I have Sensor and I have a Narset. I have good mana, so hopefully if he is playing some creature deck, I can still draw into some removal or verdict. And I think in the dark, I just have to keep this hand and hope it's good enough.
When we start with your favorite opening, Island Go.
Island Go. I'm gonna play
TikTok.
Tap Deserted Beach.
Ooh.
Go.
All right, I'm gonna play Consider.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh, that's actually a good card. I would like to have that.
What are you playing? Island and Consider.
Try them.
Go. Jeskai.
People were craving for those mirror matches, you know?
Planes, go.
This is blue-white and this is terrible. Well, we still have a chance, right? I mean, we're just gonna jam Ascendancy, we're gonna hope it resolves, and once miracle number one happens, maybe another miracle happens, and we can cast the Awakening, and maybe loot our hand into like a perfect thing, and at least if the Ascendancy sticks, Narset is not an immediate tap out, because we might just win it. Look, this comes into play on tap, because I have a mountain, and,
wow.
I knew that.
Wait, does jamming Ascendancy just expecting to
does
resolve?
It work?
No, I'm gonna Sensor.
Okay, the Ascendancy didn't stick.
Never was that my playset.
There you go.
Maybe Pioneer is not so bad if you get to play Sensor. And I've got, if you're playing Ascendancy, I have your friend right here, Narset.
Hmm. And there's Narset. Yeah, we're screwed.
I'm gonna take it down. I'm gonna take it a... Just play it super safe. March of the Otherworldly Light. And it's your go.
Yes.
Yeah.
Cast Carotid, play Stomping Ground, pass.
Carotid has Defender, right?
Well, this particular version is German, so it has Verteidiger, which means haste and +1/+1. No, it can't attack, unfortunately.
I'm going to play Hallowed Fountain, First Blood, down to 18.
Yeah.
And I guess I'll minus Narset again. Take Teferi, Hero of Dominaria, and Sigo.
All right, I'm gonna take two.
Yeah.
Go to 18 as well.
Yeah.
I'm gonna cast an Awakening.
All right, I'm gonna try to Dobbins Veto that.
Root.
Is.
Well, that is your turn.
I'm gonna cycle, end of your turn. I'm going to play Igantro. I'm gonna try and resolve Terror Hero of Dominaria. I'm gonna tick it up, draw a card, end of your, end of my turn, I'm gonna untap two blue odd dual lands, go.
All right, expressive iteration.
Sure.
So, 1, 2, 3. Not good. All right, I'm going to do this, and this, and this. And then, I mean, it's kind of the last resort. That has another Sylvan Awakening.
Yeah.
And attack Narset.
I'm gonna try and march.
I think at this point, I'm gonna As rough as the first game is, second game should be very interesting. And that's the reason we're boarding out 11 cards. All of it. All the removal spells we don't need, some of the carry teeth, which are like dead air, even a little bit of the combo, because really multiple cards of the same combo aren't that great. You just really want to go off in one turn. And then we bring all the bangers. Monastery Mentor, Malevolent Hermit, Mystical Dispute, even Silence, you know? Show him who's the boss. Silence, I kill you.
All right, well, that was pretty easy. Game one seems really, really good for my side of the matchup, plus my Narset Veto Sensor hand lined up perfectly against Thoralf's Ascendancy deck. I'm guessing sideboard games are gonna be a little trickier. He's gonna probably have more counter spells, maybe some threats. I'm not familiar with Pioneer, so I don't know what to expect. I'm gonna keep it kind of straightforward for game two. I'm just bringing in all the blue cards, boarding out a lot of the white removal spells. I'm gonna keep a couple Wanderers to interact and, you know, have Teferi maybe to interact, as well as Shark Typhoons to potentially block, and hope that's good and that works out for me.
You good?
Right. Yeah, I keep.
I keep as well.
Starting hand for game two is quite okay, you know, iteration, ascendancy. We even have a Fry, so we're not really afraid of Narset, and it's more about like building your own board state, maybe finding a window to resolve your card draw spells, and then overwhelm with cheap interaction and eventually like drive it out of control so he doesn't really know what to do. And the hand just is pretty perfect for that.
All right. Triumph, go.
Hallowed Fountain, go.
Draw, that's a bit unfortunate. Second Triumph, yeah. Go.
Allen, go.
Draw. Sanctum, Cardmarket. One blue open.
One blue
For Sensa, obviously.
I decided to just Gust the Carroted, just one for one, you know. Aether Gust is a solid card, but it's not like it's ever gonna do anything totally nuts. So given my hand, I'm just happy to trade a one for one, try and slow him down, play a Narset, and, you know, untap, probably play my Narset, and hopefully slow him down. Hopefully he doesn't have a dispute. Try and Gust your Carroted while it's on the stack.
That's disgusting. Disgusting?
Is it?
I don't know, I like my character.
Okay, I'll fight over it.
No, I will keep it, you know?
Okay.
No, I'm quite happy with it.
Alright. Draw. I'm just jamming here. Just Narset.
Works!
Resolved! Alright, minus.
I'm not afraid of Narset, and I'm pretty sure we're gonna just let her sit for a while.
It does work.
Take a Dobbins Veto.
Yes. We'll draw
the very best of Cardmarket. And then I'm gonna try an iteration.
Yeah, iteration's fine, obviously.
I'll pick this, exile this land.
Yeah.
And then play the Cardmarket.
Yeah.
And pass the turn.
All right, I'm gonna minus Narset.
Mm-hmm.
Take Absorb.
Three mana counter spells.
Yeah. All right, I have a small but interesting decision here. I can either play Island, have Deluge mana up. I feel like that's a little ambitious. I'm assuming he's gonna make me counter something, maybe an iteration. So I think I'm just gonna play the Farmland tapped, have Veto mana up for potential iteration or something else. And then it'll set me up better for later in the game. I'll have more white mana available. Irrigate, Farmland, and say go.
Go. Pressure Fortress, go.
Impressive.
The class of waiting game.
All right, I'm gonna play Field of Ruin and say go.
I have plenty of basics.
Yeah. Is that straight up strip mine? I don't even know. I'm not familiar with Pioneer deck lists.
Okay, draw one. Beautiful. And
okay,
go.
Yeah. So here's my three-step plan, right? Step one, kill Narset end of turn with Fry. Step two, silence, and then Nassif has to counter it, or not, then it's silent. Step three, profit, win.
End of your turn, I'm going to try and cast Memory Deluge.
Unfortunately that could work. All right, yeah, no, that works.
These two. Man, I might have to discard to hand size. This is terrible. Terrible, terrible, terrible life.
Cards in hand?
Eight. Can I discard to hand size?
I will try and consider. You can use mana if you want to.
I'm kind of tempted, honestly.
I know.
It is very, very tempting. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and veto. Might be game losing, but I'm gonna veto your consider.
Veto the consider.
Just so I don't have to discard to hand size.
Okay, that works.
It might be a little greedy and short-sighted, but I'm also not sure what he could have. I was thinking, you know, he has Fry, maybe he has an uncounterable threat like Chandra, six mana Chandra, something weird. So kind of slowing him down, finding these key cards might be a good idea anyways. And yeah, just gonna aggressively veto consider and hope I don't get punished too badly.
Go. I will Fry Narset.
All right, Narset's gone.
And then I'm drawing. I'm gonna try and silence you.
Silence me? That's a card? Oh my god. What have I done? How many cards do you have left?
Three.
Okay, I'm gonna lose because I got greedy and... All right, I guess I'll Dobbins veto your silence.
Oh, all right. Then let me try to expressive iteration.
Iteration's fine.
One, two, three. Okay, pick that one.
God, I'm just the greediest.
And play the fortress.
Yeah.
Pass.
Oh, it was kind of a bait. Oh,
well. Well, the silence was definitely a bait.
Yeah. I'm gonna play an island and I'm gonna chill and say go.
Just chilling. All right. Untap, draw. Oh, now that's finally something we can work with.
Oh, that little guy. Wow, that card's really good. Guess I should counter it. Absorb?
Yeah.
I gain three. I'm at 23, I think. First blood.
Well, is that blood? Like
reverse blood.
All right, I mean, let's try to disturb it.
Okay, resolves.
And it's your turn.
I'm gonna try to march.
This thing, so it's countered, huh? All right, we'll dispute the march.
Yeah.
And we go.
Do you have two cards left? All right, I'm gonna play five mana Teferi.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a decision here. Do I want to just minus or untap? I'm just going to plus to draw cards.
The Teferi plussed and didn't kill the Benevolent Hermit, which is a bit sus to me, I have to say. Did he read that card? It says can't be countered. Non-creature spells can't be countered. Pretty important.
I decide to plus because I don't have a hard counter anyways. And, you know, the passive of the Hermit is not doing much since I don't have counters for now. I'd rather draw a card, try and find an answer. So here you go.
Draw. Ascendancy.
Non-creature spells you control can be countered. Yeah, resolves. Obviously.
Obviously. All right. Opt. Trigger.
I guess I
trigger.
Cycle. In response.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Opt resolves.
First trigger resolves.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then opt.
Yeah.
Definitely not. Draw.
Mm-hmm.
Consider.
Yeah.
Same thing.
Yeah.
Consider. Sure. Take that. Opt.
Yeah. So I decided to cycle farmland as he was going off, trying to find one of my marches to get rid of the ascendancy. Yeah, I was kind of like, oh, I need to stop him from going off. But really, at that point, I think my best bet is just to hope he kind of fizzles, you know, cycles a bunch and maybe doesn't quite go off. And at least in that case, I get to cycle a shark, block, and untap with a Teferi and be in a slightly better spot than getting super desperate trying to find that elusive march. And resolve the
cards. Yeah, you're late to the party.
I don't know what it means, but okay, bottom.
You're late. Draw from opt. Funny. We're gonna smack Teferi for five.
Yeah.
And play a mentor.
Mentor? Jeez.
And yeah. Your go.
I guess.
Supreme verdict?
I guess I completely messed that game up. Yes, I kept in all my verdicts.
I mean, if you kind of know what
yeah,
they're
cycling. Yeah, no, it's true. Bold of you to assume I know what's going on in this matchup. All right, I'm going to try and resolve an Arset.
Works.
All right, I'm gonna play a 5-mana Teferi.
Okay.
And I'm gonna minus on Mentor.
So third from the top, right?
Yeah.
It's gone.
All right, go.
All right. Draw. And we're gonna. I guess we can do it like this. And cast a Sylvan Awakening.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, they don't become creatures before they do that.
Yeah.
And two, then two. We float five.
Yeah.
And play a Dig. And exile any three. Doesn't matter. So now we untap those. So they're all 3/3s now.
Yeah.
And I'm still looking at the top 7.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 15, 7. 21. And then we're gonna do it.
I mean, that's already enough.
Yeah.
All right, good game. Wow, I completely blew it. Well, I hope you enjoyed the freebie. Speaking of free things, I didn't have to bring my own deck, but how do we get the cards today?
Well, lucky that you asked me. Now, yeah, if you want cards, and of course, Pioneer is now getting big, so you want to get all your Pioneer decks ready before they're expensive, you can buy them at Karma Crow, and we basically, well, me, I'm part of Karma Crow. We have all the cards in stock, so if you want to get your Pioneer deck, you can send in the whole deck list. We're gonna prepare your deck, send them to you, mostly in like 3 to 4 days, depending know where you are. And if you click the link in the description below, you directly land on our page and can go shopping.
All right, after seeing Mentor and the Hermit, I'm gonna make a slight adjustment. I'm gonna bring back in the two Verdicts and remove the two of the Wandering Emperor. I'm not sure that's the card I should, maybe I should keep it as well to have more end of turn threats, but it's not super easy to tap out on his turn. He can punish me with Dig 3 times. So I guess I'm just going to board out the Emperor and have a couple Verdicts and things go poorly, in case things go poorly.
As much as the Xipo plan worked perfectly for game two, I'm going to get the feeling that now all of our tricks are kind of out of the back. We put them on the table and Nassif is now knowing what he has to play around, right? Mentor and Hermit are great, but they're much greater if your opponent doesn't expect it and boards out a lot of the remove spells, and even Silence is at least a very good surprise. It still trades up for mana, you know, it still needs to be answered by Vito, but I feel like this gets much tougher once we're in game three and he knows all our weapons.
I'll play first.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
And I will keep a couple disputes, four lands and a Shark Typhoon, just perfectly fine, good mana, solid hand, easy keep.
Okay, I keep as well.
Right.
This hand looks a bit iffy to the point that it doesn't do much. We have lands, we have some form of like choosing what you want to do with the hand. We have a Triome, at least one that we know we're gonna cycle, which saves a mana on the Dig 3 time in the end, which is not nothing. It's actually quite important to cast Dig 3 time with some mana back up or to be able to pay dispute. I think the hand is good enough to keep, and the game's gonna go long, so I want the lands.
That Pallid Fountain, go.
Draw, tapped, Triumph, go.
Island, go.
Draw. Tapped, Foundry.
Yeah.
Go.
I could cycle Shark Typhoon to dig, but I think I'm fine with what I have in hand right now, and I'd rather save it for making a shark, maybe on turn 4, turn 5, start applying some kind of pressure. Field of Ruin.
The strip mine.
Is it though? I don't think I've seen a basic yet. Let's see.
If I keep saying that's a strip mine, would you believe me?
I don't know. I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna Field of Ruin your Triumph.
I will float blue.
Alright.
And I'm gonna look.
Oh yeah, you literally played Island in land. All right, go.
I have the blue.
Yeah.
I'm actually gonna refrain.
All right.
Draw. Play. Glacier Fortress and Winter.
Yeah.
And let's go.
I'm gonna march your Mentor. Go.
Draw. And play green, blue, red, Triumph, and pass.
Oh, that was bad. I didn't get punished though, but that was bad. I'm gonna shock with Hallowed Fountain, go to 18.
Yep.
And say go.
I'm gonna cycle the Triumph.
Yeah.
And draw. And tap.
Mm-hmm.
And draw another one for turn. Gonna play a land tapped, and it's your turn.
And of your turn, I'm gonna make a cycle for a free, free shark.
Mm-hmm.
Draw, on tap.
Where's seed time when you need it?
Deserted beach, attack for free.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's 17.
Oh, I can, you can already smell the blood that you guys like, attack for three.
Go.
Opt.
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna accept. Accept this.
What are we doing? Proposition. Gabriel's proposition.
Well, I mean, I could decline, right?
Yeah. I not like decline. The accept.
I'm gonna accept your proposition. I'm also gonna cycle another Triumph.
Sure.
Man, how good those were. And then we're gonna draw. Mmm.
Mmm.
Juicy.
Let's play another land and pass the turn.
End of your turn, I'm gonna cycle Sensor.
Sure.
And I'm going to cycle another Sensor.
Ox.
Attack.
Yeah, 14.
Yeah. And it's your go. Yeah. Opt is fine.
Yeah, I'm gonna accept that.
Okay.
Accept this proposition. And then I'm gonna fry the shark.
Oh.
How do you fry a shark? I guess in a tornado it works.
Yeah.
All right, my turn?
Yeah.
Tap, draw. Oh, no, that's something we can do wrong with. Just an iteration.
Just an iteration. I'm gonna Dobbins veto iteration.
You don't like my iterations.
No.
It's fairly mean.
Gotta do something. I've got so many counter spells.
Go.
And your go.
Untap, draw.
Yeah.
Hmm. I will pass the turn.
All right, I'm gonna make a token.
Hey, dig through time. it doesn't matter what I keep. Huh? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
I feel like I'm kind of at the past.
Interesting.
I could take the ascendancy and go more for the combo part, or I take the silence and then be more ready, because I only have a second silence in the deck and the one I have in hand is already there, so I'm not gonna see another one, but I do see a lot of combo pieces, so I'm feeling quite good picking the silence there and then trying to craft my hand a little bit better and then gonna unload them at the same time, so Nassif has to counter at least three times if I want to combo off.
I'm gonna pick those two.
Yeah.
And it's your turn.
Attack for one.
13.
Go.
Consider.
Sure.
End of turn. I'm gonna accept this as well.
Yeah.
Untap, draw. Let's try another iteration. Because we haven't done that in a long time.
I decided to just use my gust on iteration. Kind of same thing as last game where I just gusted, turned to carried it. It's just gust is never gonna do anything amazing, so just try to trade resources and slow Thoralf down a tiny bit.
And try to ether gust your iteration.
That works. And then I'm gonna cast the Cardities.
I'm gonna try and
at least try to have double blue.
I'm gonna try to dispute your Carried.
My pure Carried.
Is that Carried that big of a deal? Save the plant, save the world.
Is that a hero reference?
Yeah.
This was very good. No, that works. She's dead.
All right.
Here you go.
End of your turn, I'm gonna cycle a Sensor.
Mm-hmm.
Attack for one.
12.
12. I'm gonna try to resolve Teferi, Hero of Dominario.
I'm gonna silence him.
Silent works.
Silent works.
Yeah. All right, go.
Draw.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess we're doing what we always do.
Yeah, iteration's fine.
One, two, three. So we're gonna pick this. We're gonna play this, and this goes back.
Yeah.
And graveyard, and it's your turn.
Draw. Attack for one.
11.
Aha. Hall of Storm Giants. Go.
Hall is not the worst. Some clock. I thought I had more time, you know? Let's try and take some time. And keep on time. That's 6, yeah.
All right, in response, I'm gonna try to Memory Deluge.
That works.
I could play it super safe, take the Dispute and Absorb. This way I have double Dispute for Thoralf Dig Through Time, meaning he can't Dispute right back. He's gonna tap out to pay for the first one, and then the second one's gonna counter. And then on his turn, I'll still have March, pitching two white cards if I'm desperate, if I need to get rid of an Ascendancy before he goes off, or maybe something like a Monastery Mentor. It does mean that if things go that way, I'll be low on resources, but maybe it'll be enough. I'll still have the Delusion in the yard, and I can also get aggro with Hall and Token. Or I could just take the Absorb, tap out, Absorb, Dig Through Time, and hope he has nothing. And then if he has nothing, I get to untap with my two Marches, a Dispute, a Shark Typhoon, and have really a ton of resources. In the end, I decide to go with the kind of safe plan to the Dispute and the Absorb. These two... I'm getting real desperate over here. I'm gonna try to Dispute your Dig Through Time.
I'm gonna pay.
And I'm gonna Dispute it again.
That works.
Go.
Oh, okay, I see an opening here. I mean, Nassif kind of tapped down to one mana. We're doing the math. We can cast the Ascendancy. We can cast the Sylvan Awakening. We have to cast the Silence after everything resolved, so our lands untap. But this is good. This is good. The only thing that can really happen is if he really has March and two white cards in his last three cards. Three cards. How likely is that? You have three cards.
Three cards, yeah.
Technically, if they're March and both white, that'd be funny. Oh well. Ascendancy.
Yeah.
Then Awakening.
Okay.
So trigger resolves.
Yeah.
Draw. Yeah. Discard.
I'm gonna March Ascendancy for.
Okay, so in response of the March, I will consider. Right? Then.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then I will trigger the Ascendancy once again. Loot. So I'm at 11. I take infinite next turn. Alright, I'll discard the Fry and then consider.
Yeah.
Definitely not. Draw. Then all of those.
Yeah.
This one is exiled as well. They
yeah.
go to the graveyard.
Yeah.
And we're gonna play a land for turn.
Sure. You have two cards left?
Two cards.
And you're at 11. Do I try to kill you?
I thought I had it.
Or do I go for Memory Deluge? All right, decision time. Do I just attack Thoralf, hope nothing much happens on his next turn, and I can present lethal, or do I cast a Deluge for 7? I drew a land, so I'll still have 2 mana up after my Deluge, meaning that if I find a Veto, I'll probably be in really good shape. And if I don't find Veto, hopefully he doesn't kill me, and I can have a lot of action going on. I think I should just go for Deluge. I feel like, okay, if I attack and he has nothing, it means that I'm probably in good shape anyways if I Deluge, right? But if I attack and he draws something like a Hermit, all of a sudden he has a blocker, or maybe Mentor plus spells, and all of a sudden my Hall of the Storm Giant plan is not effective anymore. So I feel like Deluge is kind of almost strictly superior, because if he doesn't have anything and I get to untap after having cast Deluge, I'll probably win easily anyways. All right, I think I'm gonna just main phase Memory Deluge, actually.
Interesting. Yeah.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm gonna take these two. All right, play Hallowed Fountain tapped, attack for 1, and it's your go.
10.
Go.
Untap. Something good?
No, please.
I mean, that qualifies as something good.
Oh my god. I didn't even find a veto. If I'd found a veto, it's just game, I think.
Let's look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seven. Yeah, this is the only reasonable thing we can do. All right, they go down. This goes in graveyard. And then we're gonna cast on Mr. Mentor.
Yeah.
Play a land.
Yeah.
Go. Upkeep. Silence. Trigger.
Response to silence, I'm gonna try and cast Memory Deluge.
Yeah, that works.
Alright, take these two.
Yeah, I'm gonna make a monk.
Yeah.
Then you draw.
Draw, land, why not? And go.
Untap.
Yeah.
Draw. All right, I'm gonna attack with the mentor.
Yeah, just two?
Just two, go 16. To 18. Oh, you were at 18? All right, you go to 16.
Yeah.
And pass.
I am going to make a token end of your turn.
Yeah, I'm gonna dig.
I have it. God, I'm so bad.
I will make a token, exile this.
Yeah.
And look at 7. Mana fits in it.
Punished, punished, punished.
Okay, taking those two, and it's your turn.
I'm gonna try to cast here to ferry, or to ferry here of Dominaria.
I'm gonna. Consider in response.
Okay.
Make a monk.
Mm hmm.
We can draw one.
Yeah.
This goes up.
Yeah.
Look at this. I think I need draw.
It's negate!
I guess. I can try to negate it.
It's unfortunate, I have 5 mana up, so I can either let Teferi go, cast Verdict, but then I know he has a Hermit in the yard, plus a bunch of cards in hand. I'll be left with a kind of useless, counter spells and not much else. I think I need to push my luck, fight over Teferi, hope that I just draw an untapped land. This will have Teferi plus a clear board, and then I think I'll be in a slightly better shape.
I'm gonna Dobbin's veto your negate.
Yep. Then your Teferi resolves.
I'm gonna tick up.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna play Narset.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna take down Narset.
16.
I'm gonna grab another Teferi. I get to untap 2 lands.
Alright, draw. We're gonna flashback the hand.
Yeah.
And pay 2.
Yeah.
Go to 8. Cast Awakening.
Yeah.
Animate the lands. Attack you with all of this.
Okay, block a land, block a mentor.
So I will just make a token from the
pockets.
So all of those come through?
Yeah.
Yeah, and then I'm opting.
Alright, games.
Mm.
Well, there's a lot of questionable decisions on my part. On my stream, we have a name. My viewers would call this a Nassif 3-0.
Uh-huh.
You know, classic.
It's what you're supposed to win, but
yeah, exactly.
Destiny prevented it.
Or Destiny or something else prevented it. It was just bad luck, clearly.
Man, there was just nothing I could have done, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Nothing I could have done. You just outplayed me at every step of the way, and my draw. That was a disaster. But at least, honestly, I think it's good too to see like the mistakes you can make. I say sometimes I make the mistakes so you don't have to, and I don't know from your side, you know, if it was tough or how it felt, but...
No, actually, like on one part, I had iterations in my hand for like 6 turns and I don't know where to use it, so
yeah.
Looking back at it, you can learn so much what the timing, especially on those matchups, is where you have all the instants, yeah. No, it was great, and if you want more content like this, as you said, where can they find you to see more of those Nassif reels?
Yeah, if you want to be, you know, if you want to feel good about yourself, see a Hall of Famer, make a ton of mistakes, and be like, oh,
they're also humans. Yeah.
Yeah. I stream pretty much daily, twitch.tv/yellowhat. I have a YouTube page, yellowhat, and Twitter @GamNassif. What about you, Thoralf?
Well, you can follow me on Twitter. I have the quest on ongoing. The emptiest Twitter feed of all time. Just, no, yeah, you can obviously, if you want to see more gameplay, follow this channel here. You already subscribed, I know, but leave a comment. How did you like the matchup? We have the podcast, right? You can find this on this channel or on your podcast app, the midweek metagame.
Yeah, sure, I have a podcast, so yeah, midweek metagame.
Yeah, right, listen to that and see you next time.
Yeah.
If you have any wishes, post them below and we're gonna make them happen if enough people want that.
Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Take care.